response will be, Lord, be close to give comfort. When pain or distress is overwhelming, Lord, be close to give your comfort. When the healing process goes slower than hoped,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When terrified by treatment or therapy,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When it's hard to let go of long-held plans,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When the feeling of alienation arises,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When worn out and weary,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When troubled by impatience and negativity,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When loneliness adds to anxiety,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When sickness makes it difficult to communicate,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When discouragement or despondency set in,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When fear makes it impossible to face the future,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When the ravages of disease attack self-esteem,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When anger and resentment assail,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When beset by worry or fretfulness,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When it is hard to rely on others for care,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When envy arises towards those who are healthy,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When pessimism or cynicism holds sway,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When anguish is intensified by the need for reconciliation,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When sickness is mistaken for punishment,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When loved ones are far away,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When sickness causes financial hardship that leads to worry or despair,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When afflicted by the feeling of nothing to hope for,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When weakness makes it impossible even to think,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When friends draw back fearful of disease,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When illness makes those who are suffering moody or irritable,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When haunted by regret and the shame of past sins,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When it is difficult to sleep,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When there's loss of appetite, when there's resistance to necessary change,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When tempted by denial,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When nobody seems to understand,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When bound to home or when restricted in movement,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When listlessness and apathy threaten,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When medication seems to make things worse,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When all that's needed is a caring touch,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When it is impossible to maintain familiar routines,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When it is hard to find the strength to go on,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When it becomes difficult to pray,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When suffering of any sort becomes hard to bear,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
For an end to this pandemic,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
When death draws near,
Lord, be close to give your comfort.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Most merciful Father, your beloved Son showed special compassion to lepers, tenderness to those long sick, and healing to the infirm laid before him. We place before you all those who are ill in need of your healing grace during this pandemic. May the love and mercy of the divine physician raise up all who suffer from sickness and restore them to health and peace. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
The prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O Jesus, I turn toward the Holy Sacrament.
Will you be
dimly form of me. I love you, O my God. I cannot receive you in Holy Communion. Come, nevertheless, and visit me with your grace. Come spiritually into my heart. Purify it, sanctify it, render it like unto your own. O Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. O Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. O Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please join in singing of our benediction hymn, Fontem Ergo. The divine praises.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, power of me. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. St. Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God, his angels, and his saints. May the heart of God.